What's up, y'all? It's your Raw Flying. It's Kween Kash here for Black City TV. And as you can see, I'm not alone. And I am pleased to introduce the gentleman to my side right here, Mr. Mack Wilds in the building.
What up, what up?
Chilling, man. Thank you for being here with us, first of all.
No, thank you for having me. Seriously.
All right, absolutely. We got lots to talk about, and we're just going to basically talk.
Cool.
All right, so you're a very talented man, basically. Quadruple threat. I mean, I don't even know like how many talents you actually have, but let's name the ones I do know. So producer, writer, actor, performer, singer. Wow.
Rapper.
A rapper? You got balls? No, I'm playing, I know that. Cause you know I kinda get down too, but we'll see later if I'm intimidated by Mr. Mack Wilds. You know, I mean, I'm usually like, ah, but we'll see. So we're gonna get right into it with the music side of things. All right, so New York, A Love Story. Yeah. Where did that title come about?
You know, it's crazy. When we first did the album, I had a name for it. Like, I was gonna name the album "Where the Wild Things Are," based on one of my favorite children's books. Yeah, you know, I wanted to name it that because to me, that's what it was like growing up in New York. You know, in the neighborhood that I grew up in, I felt like Max. You know, the kid around the monsters, you know, and it's kind of metaphorical in a sense. You know, you have to learn how to tame your own monsters.
Yeah. So how did it like feel representing Staten Island on your album? Because like you say it in a few songs, you know what I mean? And a lot of people are good for shouting out their borough, yeah. But we usually don't hear too much of a Staten Island shout out
at all. And it sucks because there's a lot of people from Staten Island who rep other boroughs, and it's like, fam. You left Brooklyn when you were 3, fam. Like, you're from Staten Island.
Yeah,
you're 25 years old, bro.
Own it.
Yeah, own it. Exactly, right?
Basically.
But yeah, I mean, I think it was necessary, you know, not only to represent my borough, which we, you know, no matter which borough you're from, you rep your city hard, you know, especially if you run your streets like you're supposed to.
Yeah.
But I not only wanted to rep my borough, I wanted to rep the city. You know, I wanted to rep New York, too. Like, on an extent that we weren't seeing in music a lot, you know. It was before Troy dropped New York the album. It was before it was a time where we had New York artists that were prevalent in the game, like a Nicki Minaj, like Action Bronson, like a Chance Drugs, a French Montana,
mm-hmm.
But you weren't really necessarily hearing any type of music that brought you to a certain place.
Okay.
You know, like when you hear a DJ Mustard beat, you automatically think Los Angeles. You hear YG, you think Los Angeles. Same thing with Kendrick. You know, it gives you a certain place and time. It's a worldly sound. Like, everyone can commiserate with the sound, but it's more than that. You know, you can hone into a certain place for it. And I wanted to make music like that. And the only time that I really remember hearing music like that was the 90s. You know, we had a sound. We had boom bap. So I kind of leaned on that. I just wanted to make an album that didn't necessarily have to be 90s. It wasn't because I wanted to make a 90s album. I just wanted to make an album that sounded and resonated like New York does to me.
And how do you feel that, knowing that that album resonated with so many people and that it's Grammy nominated, like, explain that moment that you found out, you heard the news that, like, yo, my album's, I'm up for a Grammy, son.
It was crazy. You know, we were still dead smack in the middle of promo tour.
Okay.
We were in Richmond, Virginia. I was in my hotel room. We were just watching the Grammy telecast, you know, so they were doing the concert and, you know, telling who was nominated and everything. And I remember watching it, and they didn't say my name. So I'm like, okay, maybe I'm just not nominated. I didn't know the rules. I didn't know they don't tell everybody who's on.
Yeah.
But then they say, if you want, you can go online and see the full list of the nominations and everything. And I just felt like, you know, I don't want to waste my time and be hurt running online to try to find out. So I'm gonna get on Twitter. Shout out my boy Kendrick, you know, because K-Dot is one of my homeboys.
Okay.
And, you know, just really, you know, just give him props because he was nominated, like they showed his name like 6 times. I was like, yo, that's crazy.
Yeah.
So, you know, I was about to go online, grab my phone, and as soon as I grabbed my phone, I get a text message from one of the label reps. She said, you did it. I said, I did what? She's like, no, you did it. You're nominated. And I think I was so excited. Like, I knew what it was, mm-hmm. but I didn't know what she was talking about. Like, okay. I knew what she was talking about, but I didn't know.
Okay.
So my next response was like, nominated for what? I don't.
You need the nomination.
I don't know what you're talking about. She said, you're nominated for a Grammy, stupid. I said, are you serious? She was like, yes, of course. I said, prove it. And I remember saying prove it because I was like, I don't want to get too excited.
Yeah.
Let me just relax. Like, prove it. I need receipts. Yeah. Like, I need to see this. I need to see it to believe it. And lo and behold, there we were. Yeah.
That's amazing. Well, congratulations again. That's like a huge, huge feat. We're definitely looking forward to like longevity in your career. This is just the beginning. So what do you see for yourself in the future as far as music and or acting?
You know, I just being a lot more creative, you know, acting wise, as if you've been with me my whole career, acting wise, you can definitely see with the trajectory of the different characters that I've played, it's always something different. You know, it's never really been the same character over and over again. And I feel kind of the same way with music. You know, with music, there's so many different genres that I'm influenced by. I feel the need to really get out the way that I'm feeling in several different ways. I'm not saying I'm gonna come out with a country album or just straight up go rock and roll on you, but you know, you will definitely feel influences of the different genres of music and the different types and varieties of songs that I really like, whether it be a gospel riff or you know, a guitar lick that sounds like something you remember from the White Stripes. You know, just different things that that really resonate with the different things that I connect to musically. So,
okay. So compare being an actor performer on that end to being a singer rapper and performing on stages. Like, what's the comparison there?
I mean, it's pretty much the same thing. You have to connect with the crowd.
Okay.
You know, I can definitely thank acting and stage work for teaching me how to connect with the crowd, how to pull emotion out of a crowd, get what you're trying to say across the right way. It's performance. It's all performance based, and it's the same thing on stage when you're acting. You know, or on a set. You know, you have to. Depending on what the performance entails and what you need to do, that's what you have to take those right steps to get that done.
Okay. So let's see. I have a little theme going. It's compare. Yeah. So now I'd like for you to try to, and you don't necessarily have to compare, but just touch on from your perspective, being on set to being in studio.
Being on set versus being on studio. I think for me the only difference is the gratification.
Is one immediate and then one
Absolutely.
Comes later?
Oh. Absolutely. Whereas on set, you know, you do a good scene, you kill it, you have to do it over and over again. People say, you know, we loved it, it was dope. You don't get the gratification of that scene until it's out on, you know, in the movies or in the film or on the television show, and you see how they cut it up, which parts they took from each take that you did to make up the entire scene. So it's not as instant a gratification mm-hmm. as doing a song is. As soon as you finish cutting a song, you can put it out to the world. Oh. Or you could, as soon as you cut the song, bring it home, you let your homies hear it, and you automatically get what they, you know,
exactly.
their you know, what they feel is dope about it, what they don't like about it. And you know, so I, that's the only difference to me. It's just a different gratification.
Okay, cool. So keeping with the theme, compare let's see, Dixon from 90210 mm-hmm. to Michael from The Wire to Mack Wilds. Three completely different.
Absolutely. Michael would be more so, you know, definitely the kid from the broken home and you know, the troubled past and who has to, you know, bear the mantle of being not only a father to his little brother, but also a mother because his mom wasn't there, just being the parent, yeah. You know, when he's still a child himself, mm-hmm. which is one of those stories that we hear too often, you know, especially nowadays, you know, a child bearing, you know, the mantle of the head of the household. But Dixon, I feel Dixon is, you know, a guy. He's literally a guy who was transplanted from his everyday world into a world of excess and lush and women, and he's learning how to navigate that and also try to keep himself out of trouble.
Okay.
Whereas Mack Wilds,
are you trying to keep yourself out of trouble?
Absolutely. Mack Wilds is a mix of both.
Okay.
You know, I'm definitely, you know, a street smart kid. I got into the business when I was about 14, 15. Started seeing success at a young age, but still living in the projects. And just kind of grew up on both sides. Like, you know how people say, you know, one side is greener than the other side? I was at a young age, at like 16, 17, at a young age, I was able to kind of have a place in the world where I was able to see both sides of the fence, where you know, I knew one side and I knew how to navigate that side, but I'm seeing this side, mm-hmm. which everybody says is greener, and starting to see the snakes in the grass. So you know, it's definitely Mack Wilds is a mix of both. Just a, you know, kid from Stapleton Projects, you know, who's super duper creative and just trying to learn how to navigate both worlds and growing up in both worlds and trying to get out of trouble.
Absolutely. So, well, let's go to the album again. I'm gonna go back and forth with you about the love story of New York. So basically, I'm gonna name something I love about New York, and you tell me what you love. And we go back and forth and we see who lose or who don't make sense first.
All right?
Cool. All right. Give you a few seconds to think about this. Uh-huh. Kween Kash versus Mack Wilds. Let's go. Uh-huh. All right. Corner store.
Chinese food.
Beef patties.
Dollar slices.
Summertime.
Italian ices.
Soho.
Harlem.
Skyscrapers.
Washington Heights.
Timberlands.
Air Force Ones.
Jesus pieces.
Mm.
You take it too long, sir. You take it too long. I'm going to just say that now. That's what's up. A little taste of things we love about New York. Mm-hmm. We definitely appreciate having your time here today on Black City TV.
Thanks,
like,
God.
Really fun to talk to. Real cool, down to earth, nice vibe. And we appreciate
thanks,
that.
Thanks, thanks.
Let people know if you want us to know, like, what else you got going on, where we could check for you, where they could follow you on Instagram, and y'all be sure to get that album.
Oh, yes.
Sure to get the album.
Hit me up on Instagram, Twitter, at Mack Wilds, MackWilds. Yes, the album is out right now, New York, A Love Story. New music video out right now, Henny Remix with me, French Montana, Busta Rhymes, and Mobb Deep. Shout out to the fans. Just be prepared for a lot more creativity, a lot more fun, and just dopeness. Just a lot of dopeness.
Dopeness.
Yeah,
that's
absolutely.
Thank you, Mack.
No problem.
All right, we out here, Black City TV, Kween Kash, Roughline is signing off. Peace.